A couple of weeks back, Skylum launched Luminar 4. At the time, I did a review of the new features and found that the editing tools and interface had changed significantly. Since then, I've noticed quite a few people struggling to use Luminar 4, especially those who used to use Luminar 3. If this is you, in today's video I'm going to help you get a better understanding of how to work with the new interface. And if you're a completely new user to Luminar, you can think of this video as a quick start tutorial. Let's get underway by looking at the library module. There are two modules you can work with in Luminar. There's the library module, where you can organise and manage your files, and there's the edit module, which we'll look at shortly to edit our image. In the library module, you can see a grid of images. These thumbnails show the images in the folder that you have selected. Folders only appear here after you've imported them. The library also allows you to create albums. An album is a collection of images that you want to group together, and you can select these images from multiple folders. When you want to add an image to an album, you can drag and drop it from the grid. The library also has some simple features to help you better manage your images. For example, you can add a star rating to indicate your best images. You can also mark images as favourites using this icon. And you can set colour labels which have any meaning that you want to attach to them. It's then possible to filter your photos to show only those with a certain star rating, or which are marked as favourites or that have a colour label. After selecting an image in the library, you can switch to the Edit module to apply your adjustments. This is where most of the interface changes occurred. To help explain the changes, I'm going to edit this image. Luminar supports the idea of looks, and these are ready-made presets you can apply to an image. You can display the installed looks by clicking the icon at the top of the interface. The different looks are then organized into categories. Once you've found and applied a look to an image, you can adjust the strength or amount of that look. Now, if you've previously used Luminar, I'm going to ask you to forget everything you know about it until we get to the end of this editing. Luminar supports a layer-based editing system. By default, every image you open has a base layer which you can adjust. When I selected one of the looks, it applied these adjustments to the image. Now, in the old version of Luminar, if you wanted to adjust an image, you needed to add individual filters from a list of about 50. In Luminar 4, you don't need to bother adding the individual filters. Instead, all the filters are available on the base layer and every adjustment layer you add to the image. You'll find these grouped under the icons on the right. For example, we've got the Essentials. Notice some of these have the titles highlighted. Those are the changes that were applied when I applied this look. Each look has its own different changes. Notice that was completely different. When you've clicked one of these icons, you notice all the filters you have available to you. In the Essentials group, I can see all the adjustment filters that help me correct and refine an image, and these are the ones you should start with. Once you've done that, you can switch to the creative adjustments for a different set of filters. Here we can see things like the sky replacement filter, as well as filters to add glowing effects. These are all examples of special effects, which is why they appear in the creative category. We also have a portrait category, and this is to help you adjust photos of people. Then there's the pro filters. which contains slightly more advanced adjustments. Now, having applied an initial look to this image, the next thing I'm going to do is fix a couple of problems. And I'll do this by clicking the canvas icon. First, I'm going to correct the lens distortion in the image, and I'll do this using the geometry controls. As I apply the adjustment, watch what happens to the vignetting problem in the corners of the frame. I'm also going to tick the option to remove chromatic aberration. Finally, I'll use the devignetting slider to lighten the edges of the frame where there's a problem with light fall off. I can also see some dust spots on my image, and I'm going to fix these using the clone and stamp mode. First, I'm going to select the area to use for my repair. I'll then configure my brush settings. Now I can paint over the areas I want to fix. When I'm finished, I can click the Done button to apply my changes. Because the clone and stamp layer that I've used creates a new copy of the image, if I go back and make any changes to my original adjustments, you won't see them. If I want to make further adjustments, I need to add my changes to the clone and stamp layer, or add another layer above this. For this example, I'll continue to work with the clone and stamp layer. I'll start by adding some adjustments in the Essentials group to refine the light and colour of my image. Notice that there's also an advanced settings section, and this appears in many of the filters. This section contains additional adjustments, and quite a few of these have come from the filters that were in Luminar 3 but aren't in Luminar 4. This is how they've managed to rationalize the filters to a more manageable list. Let's now add some structure to emphasize the shape of these rocks in the foreground. Now, because this filter affects the entire image, we need to use a mask to limit where the effect's applied. All the filters have individual masks that you can use to selectively adjust areas of the image. You can also turn the filter off and on again temporarily. I'm now going to use a couple of the professional adjustments, starting with Dodge and Burn. And I'll use this to lighten the rocks in the image slightly in certain areas. Next, I'll apply one of my favourite filters, which is the Advanced Contrast Filter. Once I'm happy with the adjustments, I can export the photo to an image file. The original RAW file, together with any adjustments I've made, stays in my Luminar 4 library. I hope this video has given you some idea about how to use Luminar, especially if you were struggling after the recent upgrade. If you found it helpful, please share it with others. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you soon for another video.